yours? Hi, everybody. So we just got back from the beach cleanup. Let me get on Facebook so I don't miss you guys' comments. So I figured I would go live while I do this because we're getting ready to go watch movies. Apparently. Then you don't come. So I wanted to try this because you know how we did the crap gummies using lemon strips? Well, lemon strips are hard to find now. When I went to Walmart yesterday, the shelves were completely wiped out of lemon strips. So if you're on the mainland, you're probably better ordering it online. Hi, Leanne. Hi, everybody on Instagram. So I'm actually live on both sides so that you guys don't miss it. And it's a Sunday, so I don't normally go live on Sunday. So this is what I did find at Walmart. They're seedless Hing cherries. So I figure if you're doing crack gummies, you know, you can do it with lemon peel, but I figure I would try it with the cherry because I like the seedless Hing cherry. And then this was also their seedless cream ume. So we're going to try these. I've not done it before. I only did it with the lemon strips with Sunny. But we're going to try it. And you know what? I'm going to do it with the Lifesaver gummies. And that's because after we ate all the gummy bears that we made with Sunny, we actually had a bag of Lifesaver gummies. So I just threw it in the mix. And it was really good with the Lifesaver gummies because of the flavors. This one has cherry, watermelon, apple, strawberry, and orange. And it tasted really good with the lemon peel or lemon strips. So we're going to try it. We're going to use the chop and prep again. And I wanted to try it with this. Oh, and I also bought lemons. So we're going to add lemon. I want to try with, I'm trying to make them wet. We're going to try. Just try, you know. So let's try this one first. This is the cherry one. So you always have to try the... Ooh. No. Oh my god, this is good. Oh yeah, this is gonna be good with the cherry. I don't know how well it's gonna chop. I never do them yet. I never tried, so we're just gonna sample. We're just gonna try. I'm making 12 boiled eggs for later on.
Well, whose fried egg is this?
Yours. So I just put a little bit of the cherry. Yeah, the cherry is good. It's not super sour. It's more sweet than sour. So we'll see if this tastes good with the kind, with the gummy bear. I mean, gummies. So I haven't done this before. We'll see because the cherries are harder than the lemon strips. So you kind of have to play with it or you're going to bust the motor in. So you guys get to learn with me right now. I don't know if it's going to work or not. I'm experimenting right now. Oh, these strips are humongous. So hopefully this works. Trial and error, guys. This is probably why Miss Sunny uses lemon strips. But she was saying lemon peel is too hard and it has seeds. There we go. Personally, I kind of liked it having chunks. I kind of liked that it had chunks in it. Because when you're chewing on the gummies, it added texture to the gummy. It wasn't just like a brown coating on the gummy bears. Because it was nice to be able to pick pieces of the lemon peel and eat that. Because I know if you use like a blender, it might chop too much. So there, it looks like this. This is the cherry one. Yeah. Good. Oh my god, this is really good. So I just did a little handful of the cherry. I'm gonna do the gummy. I didn't buy too much because we don't need that much. It's just me and the kids. That makes so little bit, y'all. The bag. Let me put this in a smaller mixing bowl. I want to be able to coat it all really good. I just washed this bowl. There, that's better. Then I'm gonna put a little bit of this cherry on it. Let's try cherry. Cherry. There. And then we're gonna do lemon. Let's try do lemon. So I already washed the lemons. Roll. And then we're gonna use this and see how much juice we can get out of one lemon. It'll be too much lemon juice for this. So I'm gonna squeeze it into this container so you guys can see the juice come out. Let me cut this. Where's my knife? Oh, that's the fillet knife. What the heck is going on over here? Everybody just shoves all their stuff. Okay, so cutting in half. And then this is our zest impress. I haven't demoed this in a while for you guys, but this is how it is. And the best way to use it is you want to put the lemon this way. So put it down this way. You would think it goes this way, but let me, I'll give you an example. So you do this because it pushes it inside out. Just like if somebody was to put an elbow in the middle of your back, you go like this. That's what the lemon does. The lemon does this. So I'm going to put this in here. I'm going to squeeze it. Ooh, smell good. And then what I do is I flip the lemon over and I squeeze it another time. And then turn it one more time and squeeze it the last time. And then you can save your lemon peel and make your own crack seed lemon peel. Ooh, thanks, Malia. She gave me a recipe for sweet dried lemon strips. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Is that a recipe or is that a link to order it? I think it's a link to order it. Hi, Dio. Okay, so that's half a lemon. I'm going to save the lemon peel. I use that for cleaning. Again, you want to do that because you want to jack it in the spine. Hi, Anthony. I'm making lifesaver gummies. Wow, that's a lot of juice from one lemon. These are already made, Mom. Flip, squeeze. And it actually comes with a zester, so you can zest into that cavity, but the zester is in the drawer. This one get choked seeds inside. So I always squeeze lemons 3 times. Look, all of pulp is coming out. Good stuff. Okay. Then you just wash that. I think a couple seeds fell in there. Let me get a fork. So we're gonna mix this in there with the lifesavers. Just trying something different. Oh, the lifesavers gummy smells good. There was like another tiny, tiny seed that fell in when I flipped the skin over. There it is. Oh, come on, get out. I don't want to stick my finger in here because that bugger is so small. It wants to stay in the mix. There we go. So right here we have the gummy with the seed with the cherries. So I'm just gonna pour a little bit, like a couple teaspoons maybe. I don't want to make it too much because it's going to be too sour. But you know what? Because I'm using the Hing dried cherry, the sour actually might be good because the lemon strips are pretty tarty. The cherry is not. And from what I understand, it tastes better when you let it marinate. Let's try. Hi, Sunny. I'm doing the gummies. Oh my god, that's really good. Hey! Should try one fit over there. Oh my god, this tastes really good like this. Oh my god. What I can make with some edibles. Food dehydrator would work too, Malia. So because it's wet, it looks a little bit different than the dry one. But you have to get some cherry with the, like this. Oh my god. Oh, this is winner. Oh my god. So I used, this is what I used instead of the lemon strips. This one. Sunny, the ones that we made was gone. Like that night, the kids was beefing for it. So I used this I use this and a little bit of lemon juice. So wait, I gotta store it because we're going movies. We gotta save it. So I mixed it already. I'm gonna put it in the 3-in-1. I'm gonna make dry wet. Ooh, I bought that. I have that. I'm gonna do that next. So for the cherry one, when you put it in the chop and prep, you don't want to overfill it because it's thicker than a lemon strip. So you don't want to overload it or it's gonna have a hard time chopping. You kind of have to help it along. So I'm gonna put this in the 3-in-1 container that is available right now because I want to see how well it keeps the wet and dry segregated. Because this would be a really good container to like bring snacks into the theater. You know what I mean? Okay. So it filled it up like halfway. Because that's one of the questions I get a lot is, does it keep wet? Does it keep it separated really well? It does. Because if you look at where how it sticks in here, it looks almost like a dovetail. Almost like a dovetail joint. Oh my god, it's really good when it's wet, Sunny. Like that. Hi, Tammy. And I use this one because the flavor. So let's try the seedless cream ume seed. Let's try this one. Have I eaten this before? I don't remember. Oh, it smells good, the lemon juice, you guys. Okay, we'll try. You always have to taste first. Ooh, this thing is good. Oh my god, okay. I need water. Sorry. I know I'm smacking my lips and all that, and you probably find it disgusting, but it's hard not to with this. I know, right, Sunny? So let me just try with a little bit first, because this one is thick. You know, like bust a mortar. So let's try. So this one, I'm gonna do one batch dry and one batch wet. Ooh, the bug out work. Look at this, Sunny. Look, it works. Okay, I gotta do a little bit more. I hope you guys' mouth is watering because mine is. Oh. I'm just gonna chop them all up. I think it works good. There. Let's see. How much is this? 3 ounces. Let's see. Overload it. So Sunny, I was telling them like you could use like a bullet or you could use like a blender. But sometimes it's hard to control, yeah? Because you want it to still have some texture without it turning into a complete powder. If the string is hot. Oh yeah, it is. It's warm. Okay. So there, ooh, wow, look at that. Ooh, the bug will work. Hi, Ty. Amber, your mouth is watering. Okay, so now let's do one. You know what? I don't have enough gummies. Oh, I have Smurf gummies. I can use that one. It's really good with the Lifesaver gummies. I know Sunny likes that happy yummy one. Let's put a little bit of this. This is the creamy ume, seedless. Cream ume? Creamy? Forget. It's good with this, man. Tell you. The cherry one was good. What's with the screaming? Okay, let's add the lemon juice. If you guys missed it, I squeezed some lemon juice in here with the gadget. What is the problem? Oh my god. So this is the cream ume. This one. That's what I use. I'm ignoring it, you guys. Okay, mixing. So again, the wet one, if you let it marinate, all the flavors mingle. It's like when you marinate kalbi. Okay, so let's try. I put choke ume in here. or choke for the mainland guys is a lot. Okay, try. Mmm. Ooh, this is good. Ooh. Mmm. Oh my god. It's really good with this, Sunny. This one right here. This one is winner. Mmm. You could, Sunny, use sugar-free gummies, but watch out, because sugar-free candies like that makes you poop a lot. And the seedless, all these things have a lot of sugar in it, so you can't really make this keto. Mmm, oh my god. Ooh, that is good. Yeah. This is all coming with us to the movies. I should pack chopsticks, because it would be easier to eat with chopsticks, y'all. Rather than everybody stick their grubby hands in them. Okay, so I'm going to make another one using this, because I already chopped up all this, the cream ume seeds. And I'm going to use the Smurf gummies. This is good for, like, you know, after, like, Halloween and stuff, when you have all that candy from Halloween time, and you don't know what to do with it. This is a good way to, like, change it up so that everybody eats it. All these out, and we're just gonna mix it all up together. This is, I don't know what flavor Smurf is. What flavor is Smurf? Oh, this thing is super chewy. I know, Emmy. We're making more crack gummies, but I'm kind of experimenting with the with different kind Lihing Mui. So I did one with cherry. And I did one with the cream ume seed, the seedless ones. I don't think you can go wrong mixing gummies with any of our, any crap seed, honestly. Oh. This just tastes like gummy. There isn't really a flavor to it. It says fruit, but I don't know what fruit. Any kind of fruit. Okay. You know what? I like the wet one. Okay, but you know what? These gummies are super sticky, so I don't think you have to put lemon juice to make it stick. Hi, Noe. This is the cream ume. See how tacky the Haribo brand is? It's super tacky. It doesn't need lemon juice. So we're gonna leave this one dry because it all sticks to it. It's sticking to the Smurfs. Hi, Bobot. Hi, Lavellini. You could mix the cream stuff, the cream ume with the cherry, and it can still taste good. Does like the kind of crack seed make you poop? Cause it's like prunes, yeah. Hi, Susie. We're making more crack gummies, but I'm making it with different kind of seed. I still have lemon juice. I'm just gonna pour it in there. I don't want to waste. Oh, it smells so good. So Malia on Facebook shared a link to where you can order the lemon strips, but you can also order it direct from like Jade. If you go look up Jade lemon strips, they have a website. There's also Lynn's Hawaiian Snacks, Wholesale Unlimited I think sells online too. Hopefully they have in stock, because you could at Azriel, you have to just order it online. It's really about if they have stock. So right now, like when I go to the stores, a lot of the seedless Lihing Mui stuff, the shelves are like empty. Your best bet would be to go Chinatown and get it from like the mom and pop kind stores where they sell it in big jars with the tongs hanging on the side, because they have it and it's probably cheaper. Mango, you could do mango, yes. Mango is, they sell dried Lihing mango. They do. So that's it. I just wanted to go live with you guys today. Since I was making this and I'm telling you, this craze thing, Sunny wasn't joking. It's like really, really popular. And I had no idea. And so people are like making it and selling it. So if you don't want to make it, you can buy it already made. And everybody has their own twist on how to do it. So there really is no right or wrong way to make it. You missed the crack seed store? Me too. They don't have it like before, back in the day when like every town had like their neighborhood crack seed store with the glass jars.
I mean, we still have that porridge, but it's so different now.
So, au pao. So now we have our crack gummies in here. And you know what? It's doing a good job of keeping it all segregated, including the juices. Which doesn't really matter because they, oh, it's heavy. So let me put this on. This is what I used to bring it to the barbecue after Sunny came. And the kids were like beefing for it. They were bringing Ziploc bags to me so they could pack their own stash and hide it. Hi, Gidge. Yeah, it's called crack gummies. I posted the recipe for this on a previous post. So it's all done. So it just has to marinate and then we'll pack toothpicks. I mean, what you call that? The Mui Lab. Yes, they, I heard that the Mui Lab makes alcohol ones too. So if you want to just buy it, you can go to the Mui Lab. They're on Instagram. Au pao. But this thing is good by itself. Okay. So we have to get ready for the movies now. I will see you guys later. I meant to like not, I was fasting and I wasn't supposed to eat until 1 o'clock, but I just broke my fast by eating those gummies. But that's okay. Tomorrow's a new day. The last time I ate was like at 9 o'clock last night, and it's what, 10, 11 now? 13 hour fast. Not bad. Okay, so I'll see you guys later. Can you say bye? Yeah, say bye. Come here. Come here. Come. She's playing up there. We just came back from the beach. Come here. Say bye, everybody.
Bye.
See you guys later. Bye. Bye. Blow a kiss. Can you blow a kiss? Ma, blow. Yay. Can I have a kiss? Can I have a kiss?